वेदसार शिवस्तोत्रम्। पशूनां पतिं पापनाशं परेशं गजेन्द्रस्य कृत्तिं वसानं वरेण्यं जटाजूटमध्ये स्फुरद्गांगवारिं महादेवमेकं स्मरामि स्मरारिम्। महेशं सुरेशं सुरारातिनाशं विभुं वेश्वनाथं विभूत्यंगभूषं विरूपाक्षमिन्द्वर्कवन्नी त्रिनेत्रं सदानंदमीडे प्रभुं पंचवक्त्रम्। गिरीशं गणेशं गले नीलवर्णं गवेन्द्रादिरूढं गुणातीतरूपं भवं भास्वरं भस्मनाभूषितांगं भवानीकलत्रं भजे पंचवक्त्रम्। शिवाकांतशंभो शशांकार्धमौले महेशानशूलिं जटाजूटधारिं त्वमेको जगत्व्यापको विश्वरूप प्रसीद प्रसीद प्रभो पूर्णरूप। परात्मानमेकं जगद्बीजमाद्यं निरीहं निराकार ओंकार वेद्यं यतो जायते पाल्यते येन विश्वं तमीशं भजे लीयते यत् विश्वम्। न भूमिर्न चापो न वह्निर्न वायुः न चाकाशमाशास्ति न तन्द्रा न निद्रां न चोष्णं न शीतं न देशो न वेशो न यस्यास्ति मूर्तिस्त त्रिमूर्तिं तमीडे। अजं शाश्वतं कारणं कारणानां शिवं केवलं भासकं भासकानां तुरीयं तमः पारमाद्यन्तहीनं प्रपद्ये परं पावनं द्वैतहीनम्। नमस्ते नमस्ते विभो विश्वमूर्ते नमस्ते नमस्ते चिदानंदमूर्ते नमस्ते नमस्ते तपोयोगगम्य नमस्ते नमस्ते श्रुतिज्ञानगम्य। प्रभो शूलपाणे विभो विश्वनाथ महादेव शंभो महेश त्रिनेत्र शिवाकांत शांत स्मरारे पुरारे त्वदन्यो वरेण्यो न मान्यो न गण्यः। शंभो महेश करुणामय शूलपाणे गौरीपते पशुपते पशुपाशनाशिन् काशीपते करुणया जगदेतदेकः त्वं हंसि पासि विदधासि महेश्वरोऽसि। त्वत्तो जगद्भवति देवभवस्मरारे त्वय्येव तिष्ठति जगन्मृडविश्वनाथ त्वय्येव गच्छति लयं जगदेतदीश लिंगात्मके हरचराचर विश्वरूपिन् लिंगात्मके हरचराचर विश्वरूपिन् इति वेदसार शिवस्तोत्रम्। श्री गणेशाय नमः। ओम श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। ओम समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम्। ओम श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पाद शंकरं लोकशंकरं। ओम कर्पूर गौरम करुणावतारम संसार सारम भुजगेन्द्रहारम सदा वसंतम हृदयारविंदे भवम भवानी सहितम नमामि। हरि ओम। पशूनां पतिं पापनाशं परेशं स्मरामि। आई रिमेंबर, I meditate, I become aware of their presence. Who is that? Lord Shiva, who is indicated here as Pashunam Patim, Pashupati. Even though the common general meaning of the word Pashu is an animal, but in the larger meaning, all jivas of this world, other world, all jivas are also included in that. Now, but a common meaning also when it is said Pashu, an animal, and you call that you are behaving like an animal. What is the meaning then? So the simple meaning there is called Pashyati, na chintayati. The one who sees, and whatever is seen, that is taken true on face value. There is no enquiry. Then that is called Pashu Lakshanam. In other words, ignorance and the living that life only. A cow or a goat see the green grass and goes and eats, but doesn't think why it is green. Our famous story of Newton, the fruit fell down, he was thinking why it came down, right? But other word, why are you thinking? Why can't you eat? So if this type of only tendency is there about everything, then that is called living in ignorance, no inquiry. That is the meaning. But of course, there are many people, they are thinking beings. So all are that but called Pashus. Pashu Nam Patim, Pashupati Bhagavan. Papa Nasha. His name itself is purifying. So if we chant the name, that itself is Pavanam. Of course, if anybody has done papas and prays to Bhagavan, he can destroy all those sins. Paresham, he is the Supreme Lord. Gajendrasya Krittim Vasana. Already you have seen Gajendrasya Krittim here, that wrapping his body with the hide of that elephant called Gajendrasya Krittim. Varenyam, most adorable, worshipful. The next line is Jatajuta Madhye Sphurat Gangavarim Mahadeva Mekam Smarami Smararim. Jatajuta Madhye. Jatajut, matted locks of hair, that's called Jataj. And in that Jatajut Madhye Sphurat Gangavarim. Varim is waters. Gangavarim, Gangaji water. Gangaji only. Sphurat. Sphurat means shining and Sphurat means sporting. You see here. Do you see? Jatajuta Madhye Sphurat Gangavarim. Now, see, Ganga Avatarana Katha is very famous. It is found out the origin of Gangaji is from the toe of Bhagavan Vishnu. Therefore, one name of her is Vishnupadi. In the heavens only, and to bring her down here, the great tapas was done by Raja Bhagirath to sanctify his ancestors. That is a long katha. So he prayed. Gangaji said, yes, I will come. But who will be able to hold my force when I come from such height? So only you have to tell who can do that. Only Shankar Bhagavan is capable. So now you pray to him. Bhagirath Raja did tapas and he pleased Bhagavan Shivji. He said, yes, I am ready. So when Gangaji was coming down, I tell you, if you see the description, Gangaji is quite playful, huh? Very playful, sporting. Oh, just she came gushing with so much of force. So when she came on the head of mastaka of Shivji, she started playing her some pranks as it were. Bhagavan said, "Acha, you are playing with me." So Bhagavan round his Jatajuta, so got there only. So she was only moving there only Jataju. Jata Shankari Nama Paryoge. And that's why Gangaji is called Jata Shankari. Because she was a Shankar ji ki jata mein sama gayi aap. And the Bhagavan Shivji is so wonderful. He can go in meditation anytime, anywhere, in whichever condition. So now Bhagirath Raja said, now the Gangaji has come here, but now what is the use now? Is that Bhagavan has locked her there. Locked in. Sir, locked in kar diya. So, again he put Bhagavan, please. So, Bhagavan was pleased. And slowly he released. That's why it is Jata Juta Madhye Sphurat Gangavarim. And that he came to this Prithvi Loka, purifying. So, that Gangaji, she Tripathagami, she is in the heavens, she is in this world, she also goes to the Patal Lok. And in Patal Lok, Gangaji's name is Bhogavati. Here also so many names are there, Bhagirathi, Ganga. And the very name of Ganga is Gayantam Gamayati. Those who sing her name, Ganga, Gangeti Obhuryat. Wherever you are, thousands of miles away from her. But if you remember Ganga, Ganga, Gamayati, she leads. She leads you. Where? It depends upon where you want to go. I want Bhagavat Charanarvind, from where you came, Gangaji. Okay, I will tell you there. Somebody says, I want moksha, I want bhakti, I want. So she said, Gamayati, Swalaksham Prati, leads. Therefore, Gangaji. And if you don't say anything and all that, then she will take you to Bay of Bengal. Ganga, seeing that Ganga, that Pavitra Ganga, that is there. That's why Bhagavan Shivji's name is Gangadhara. Gangam Dharayati iti Gangadhara. Her name is Jatashankari, because she was in Shankarji Jata. Therefore, Gangaji's name became Jatashankari. But Bhagavan Shivji's name became Gangadhara. Jatajuta madhe sphurat. What a beautiful word, sphurat. Sphuram, throbbing, playing, sporting, shining. Gangajalam pavitram. Mahadevam swarami. Mahadev. One means Mahashchaso Devascha. He was a great god. One means Devanam Devaha, God of Gods, that's called Mahadeva. Here we have already seen that this Bhagavan Shivji is Sachidananda Brahma. Then he is the Ishvara from whom all the Brahmandas, all Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, all of them came. This Mahesha, when we talk, that also Bhagavan's Vibhuti only, all of them came there. So therefore, he is Deva of Devas or not? Therefore, he is called Mahadeva. In the Puranas, there are some wonder, interesting stories are there. Sometimes there is dispute between Brahmaji and Shivji. Brahmaji and Vishnuji. Then Shivji comes and resolves it. Interesting kathas are there, and they have got, you know, rochakta, but we had to also learn how to think about them. We'll try sometime, whatever is possible. But Mahadev, Devanam Deva, right? Mahadev he is. So now, in this way here also we can see, these three devatas, they come through Rajogun, Sattvogun, Tamoguna, right? In our mind also, there are conflicts are also not. Sometimes Rajoguna Vritti comes, then Sattvoguna Vritti comes. Right? Conflicts are there. The only way is the rising above all the three gunas, when our attention is shifted to that Chidananda Rupa, then we'll find all this will get resolved. What are you talking about? Right? Suppose two brothers are there and they are also quarreling, fighting, you know. And the parents come or someone else comes and then you are brother, same family you are. What are you conflicting? So when the attention is turned towards something higher than these two, and if they see that, then it is resolved. This is the practical meaning of that. Okay? Mahadevam. And that Mahadev can be Ekam only. Because God of Gods, there cannot be many. But there will be so many problems then. Ekam, when you say Ekam eva advitiyam, one alone without a second. The Supreme Lord only can be just one. There are other so many deities and so many others, that is possible. Right? So therefore, Mahadeva, Mahashyaso Devascha, he is a great God, God of all gods, because from him only all powers are delegated to all of them. He is one. He doesn't have to get power from anyone else. That's called Mahadev. Can you find the word Pashupati is always reserved only for Shivji? Generally, Mahadev word also is used only for Shivji, right? Even though Mahadev means great God, but the moment you say Mahadev, Har Har Mahadev, oh, only Shivji. Smarami. So I remember that Lord. Pashupati, Papanasham, Paresham, Krittivasaha, Varenyam, Gangadhar, Mahadeva Ekam, Smarami. And whom do you remember? Shivji. Who is Shivji? Smarami, Smararim, Smararim, Smarami. What a beautiful word. Smarami, I remember. Now see, this word comes from Smru Dhatu. Smru means to remember. Smarami is a verb. I remember. And we say, Smaravaram Varam. Then Smar is a verb. You always remember. Always remember. Then Smara, only Smara as a verb it is there. Smarami, I remember. Smarati means he remembers, right? Now this smara also is a name, noun. It is a verb also and smara is a name. And that name is given to Kamadeva, the god of love. In English, they found Cupid, C-U-P-I-D. Now, that Kamadeva's one name is Smara. And Smarari, immediately if you translate it, the enemy of Smara. Smara means Kamadeva, the god of love, passion and all that. Bhagavan cannot be enemy of anybody. That we must remember. But when he was in meditation, the Kamadeva came to disturb. That is another long story and all that. I don't have to go into that. But this Kamadeva is given this name Smara. How? See, Smarati, active voice, singular. He remembers. But it is Smarayati, it is Smaraha. Causal form it is. He who makes you remember, Utkanthayati ityarthaha. He who excites you. Simple. And we know that any kind of desire that arises in our mind from ordinary of this of picnicking and eating, drinking, playing, sporting, sensual desires and all that, what particularly when it excites the mind or not. Therefore, the Kamadeva called Smara. The moment that thought of remember anything of pleasure, and sometimes such irresistible desire arises that lust and passion particularly when it arises, sensuous kind of thing, that you call smara. Smarayati, utkanthayati, excites you. So when it is said, Lord Shiva is what tapas, this Kamadeva was sent by God, that is long story, for some purpose and all that. And Kamadeva knew that if I go there, that is the end of me. But doesn't matter. To achieve some person, even if I die, doesn't matter. And he comes there. And Bhagavan opens. And it is said, he was reduced to ashes. But Bhagavan is very compassionate. It is said that Kamadeva's wife is Rati. She came and crying and said, Bhagavan, what do you do? Bhagavan said, all right. His form is gone, but in formless form, he will be there in the hearts of all. And that's called Ananga. Therefore, Kamadeva's another name is Ananga. No body Can you point out any particular body of desire? This is the hand, this is the leg. Oh, in the form of desire, that is there present. In all jivas, all those gods also. Exciting. And Bhagavan said, oh, in Krishna avatar, he will get the form. The story in the story, it will go, but that is not necessary. So how many names are there of this Kamadeva? One is called Kamaha only, or Kamadevaha, Smaraha, Anangaha, Madanaha. So many names are there of this. Now, enemy, that word should be understood. Here, enemy, Shatru, but Bhagavan is, how can you have a Shatru of anybody? So, here, Smarari, Kamari, word should be understood as a conqueror of this Kama. He subdued it. They cannot overpower Bhagavan. Not that enemies are with anger and dvesha and all that and hatred and all. Not that way. So it is said that Bhagavan, I remember and meditate. So now what is the implication? If you just see the story, and Bhagavan burned that Kamadeva. But in our mind, how many desires keep rising and they excite us? We become so passionate, lusty. How many and under the sway of that karma, wrong things also we do, so many things. All papa karmas we generally do, karma and krodha. So idea is, if we always remember the Lord who is the conqueror of desire, so if any such kind of anti-Bhagavan thoughts come, irreligious and then unspiritual and immoral desire, immediately, just say, Shiva, 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 Shiva. Bhagavan, please protect my mind. Please protect my mind. Please protect my mind. Tanme manah Shiva Sankalpa Mastu, Shiva Sankalpa Mastu. Immediately shifted. That is the meaning here. Otherwise, we'll see, yeah, that's the glory of the Lord Shiva. But Smarami, in this way, that in our mind when Nidhas arrives. Kamadi khaladala ganjanam. That is called this. Pashunam patim papanasham paresham gajendrasya krittim vasanam varenyam जटाजूटमध्ये स्फुरद्गाङ्गवारिं महादेवमेकं स्मरामि स्मरारिं. See how this smara, smara word, how that is beautifully used here. See the sahitya part of it, grammar part of it, and all that. So now we'll see the second shloka now. Mahesham Suresham Surarathinasham Vibhum Vishwanatham Vibhutyangabhusham Virupaksham Indvarkavanni Trinetram Sadanandamide Prabhum Panchavaktram Sadananda Mide Prabhum Panchavaktram. Now, here the verb is Ide. Ide means I praise, I sing the glories of the Lord, I praise. Whose glory you see? Mahesham, Mahesham. Again, what was called as Mahadeva, it's called Mahesha. महांशसौ ईशश्च एज द लॉर्ड ऑफ ऑल लॉर्ड्स ऐश्वर्य रूप दैट महेश सुरेशम सुरेशम सुराणाम ईशः सुरेशः. नाउ यू सी सुर मीन्स ऑल दी देवताज इन द हेवन दे आर कॉल्ड सुर. जनरली इफ द आदि लॉर्ड ऑफ ऑल दी देवताज इन द हेवन इट्सेल्फ इज इंद्र भगवान. बट इंद्र भगवान लॉर्ड इज लॉर्ड शिवा. सो हियर व्हेन वी से सुरेश इज नॉट इंद्र बट सर्वदेवानाम ईशा सुरेश. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ योर सुर एटिमोलॉजिकली हाउ इट इज सेड सुष्टु राति ददाति इति सुरः. He who gives you, blesses you, sushtu, with good thing, it's called Suresh, Suraha. That's why I said, when we pray to God, then the God bless in return. That's why in the Bhagavad Gita I said, you know, Devan bhavayata nena te deva bhavayantuha. You propitiate these gods. They will bless you in turn. So that is meaning of sura. Na suraha, asuraha. The one who is not sura is called asura. Generally you call it a demon and all that, what you call them, you know. They don't. They will give you trouble. So whatever is given also, my God, they will try to see it is snatched away, taken away and all that, you know. So they are called asura vritti. If you cannot give something good, at least don't snatch it away. But the asuras, you know, they wanted to become powerful and they should take away all power from all gods and all that. That is stories, you know, in Purana you find. So it is not only devata, here also you'll find everywhere. Huh? If you cannot give something in dhanam, it's all right. But somebody has given something to someone, why are you taking it away? Asura means who is not a sura or is the opposite of the sura then. Asura. Idea is these gods are capable of blessing us in so many ways. But if you ask that Indra Bhagavan, please give me your own seat. What? You will not give. Other than that, what? Yes, yes, you can take that. But their own seat of power, they will give you. See? Moksha and all that also, they are not capable of giving. That's why called Suresham is what? All of them, other than these gods, they have got certain powers. They can bless, they can give, that is right. But Sarvartha Siddhi is only from the Supreme Lord. Everything that what you want. Shreya, Preya, Bhoga, Moksha, whatever that you do. Everything you can get from them. They are called Suresh. Mahesham, Suresham, Surarathinasham. Surarati Nasham. Nasham means he was the one who destroys. What does he destroy? Arati. Arati, the meaning is enemy. Sura Arati means those who are the enemies of Suras, Devatas, those who take away all the powers. See, the Supreme Lord bless certain devatas that you be the Indra and all of that. So how the asuras have got the power to take away that which is given by the Lord? So what the story in Puranas, what we find that the implication we must understand also. They used to fight with devatas, take away their power, sit there. So many enemies all the time. Sometimes the gods used to be helpless. And as I said yesterday also, these asuras also had tremendous power of tapas. And they also had many boons. So they could do that. Because after all, here in this world also, when you find those who are wicked people or dushta, and they also got their own powers. If nothing else, you know, nuisance values. Even if they cannot destroy completely, but they'll go on and that will go on doing nagging. A mosquito directly can't approach, but it's so annoying, you know. But we cannot blame mosquito because that's a jiva's nature only, you know. We have to have compassion to mosquito also. Bichara kya karega? But idea is, these asuras were like that. Arati means enemies. So he is the destroyer of the enemies of Sura. So this is with reference to Adi Daivik world. But here also, how many that other people, they go on troubling the good people. Hanumanji is Rudravatar, no? Sadhu santake tumarakware asura nikandana ramadulare. So because Rudra roop hai na, so surarati nasham. So those who go on giving trouble to sadhus, then it's why. In our own mind, also subjectively also we should come here. In our mind also, noble thoughts are there and the other thought, they go on trying to, you know, tempt us, push us into that other things and all that, you know. This is constant struggle going on in our mind. And we find so helpless. Turn the mind to Bhagavan. Bada rakhwara ramapati jasu. And then when Bhagavan himself protects your mind, then nobody can do anything. In Srimad Bhagavat, there is one story. Swayambhu Manu doing tapas, and many rakshasas were coming and troubling him, but he continued Ishavasyamidam. And Bhagavan came and finished all of them. So asuras, rakshasas. He stayed there. That is called Surarati Nasham. Oh, yeah, time. Beautiful, these epithets are there, you know. So contemplative they are. Om Namah Shivaya. 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 Uma Pati Mahadeva ki jai. Shri Sadguru Nath Maharaj ki jai. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.